in Tennessee. I'm in Knoxville, Tennessee, and I had to get gas before I went home. I had to get gas before I returned my rental car and went to the airport. And so I went to a place called, Weigel's. I went to a place called Weigel's, and they had a big sign out front that said, "We have eggnog." And I was like, oh my, oh no. What do you mean, gas station? Why are you advertising your eggnog so hard? They have not one. They have two signs that are like, "Get your gas station eggnog here at Weigel's, a Tennessee tradition, dying at a gas station." So I said to myself, I can't, my flight is, by the way, my flight is in like an hour. And I have stopped to drink this. Weigel's gas station eggnog. It has, oh my God. I'm gonna see if you can see this nutrition label. This has 640 calories. This bottle has, this is like a turkey. This is like eating a turkey dinner. Oh my God. Weigel's premium eggnog. It says non-alcoholic on it. But luckily there's enough alcohol in my system anyway that it'll all kind of work out in the wash. This has 15% of my calcium. That's pretty exciting. It's got 7% of my vitamin A. Oh, and it's got 100% of my death warrant on it. Okay. Well, you guys came to see a show, and I am a showman, and I have a bottle of gas station eggnog between my legs. I'm opening it up. Oh, God, please don't spill over my pants. I only have two pairs of pants. That's the cap. You can see there's some caked-in goodness in every... There's a little bit of love in every cap. Okay. Well, to my lack of health, Stereo's Coconuts about to drink some gas station eggnog. Oh, this tastes really good. This tastes fucking fantastic. In case you're wondering, yes, I did just kill the whole bottle. See if I can prove it to you. As you can see, nothing's coming out but my future hopes of getting married again. Nothing's coming out. Oh my God, that tasted so good. Oh, I was expecting much worse from gas station eggnog. Weigel's, you get the boisterous coconut seal of approval. Well, the only thing I could think to wash this down with would be this gas station hot dog. I mean, the eggnog tasted so good. I mean, I might as well go for broke, right? Okay, as you can see, it's a delicious Weigel's gas station hot dog. Let's, why does this taste good too? Why does all this food taste... I'm moving to Tennessee. I'm moving to Tennessee. Holy shit. Weigel's. Weigel's, I came here to shit on you, and you proved me wrong. This is a super good hot dog. I'm gonna have one more bite. Okay. Total calories consumed so far, 670 plus, about 150. Let's say about 800 cap, 850. Let's say about 850 calories, give or take. Again, very good gas station hot dog. Oh my gosh. Well, I guess that's about it. Unless, of course, I eat this gas station barbecue riblet. Oh my god! Look, I've shit on the eggnog and the hot dog, and they both turned out to be pretty good. I've got nog in my beard. Wow. Just like at the strip club last night. Well, let's see about, I just wouldn't call it a riblet, that's all. I wouldn't call my sandwich a riblet. It makes it sound gross. But let's find out if it tastes gross. All right. Ooh, wait, ingredients. The first ingredient is pork. I was not expecting that. It's got tomato paste, high fructose corn syrup, water, regular corn syrup. Wow! It's got both kinds of corn syrup in it. Oh my god! They're like, should we really spend all our money on high fructose corn syrup? Let's put some low fructose corn syrup in there too. Okay, my stomach is starting to react now. Everything was funny until just now. Okay. Feels like someone turned the washing machine on in my stomach. Maybe not everything's hilarious, Asterios. Maybe life isn't one big sketch comedy routine where you can turn on Facebook Live and drink an entire container of gas station eggnog followed by half a gas station hot dog and just assume everything's gonna be okay. Maybe you're not 24 anymore, Asterios, and maybe your body's trying to tell you something. Maybe this is the sign you needed to change. Maybe this is the moment you were looking for, where you said to yourself, no more silliness, no more gags, no more jokes. It's time to grow up. It's time to grow up and get real. God, my stomach hurts so much. I wonder what it could be. Could it be my decisions? The decisions I make in my everyday life? No. Couldn't be that. Maybe it's just Tennessee air. All the pollution. Boo, Trump. Okay, this does taste bad. All right. I found the thing that tastes bad. Oh, God. Okay. Okay. All right. Oh, God. I feel like there's a midget jumping on my stomach. I'm sorry. I feel like there's a little person jumping on my stomach. So long. Look how gross this looks. So long, Riblet. I feel bad for the garbage. I feel bad. That poor what did that garbage do to deserve that Riblet? Well, guys, that's about it for me. I want to thank you guys so much for tuning in. And it's Christmas. I mean, that's why I had the eggnog. You know, Christmas is coming. If only I had a gas station fruitcake. Wait, I do. The one I'm holding in my hand. Yeah, that's right. Gas station fruitcake. This is a pound. This is a pound of matter that I bought for $3.89. It's been the choice of millions since 1910. It is. It's an old-fashioned Claxton fruitcake baked in the Deep South according to a famous old Southern recipe and put in a gas station according to a famous old Southern legend that people will buy fruitcakes and eggnog at gas stations. It has, oh wow, this entire fruitcake is 1,600 calories. It's like two bottles of eggnog. Oh my god. Alright, let's fucking do this. One sec, boys and girls. I assume mostly boys. Whoop. Don't hang up. I'm gonna need all of you to call 911 on my behalf should anything go wrong. Hey! This is the last thing most women see. Okay. I'm getting this egg. We're getting this fruitcake open.
Wow, they lock this fruitcake up really tight. They do not want just anybody getting into the fruitcake. Okay. All right.
Just like Grandma used to buy, okay? Well, I've done the gas station eggnog. Done the gas station eggnog. Oh, yeah, that hurts. Oh. Tastes even better on the way up. Hey, Marley. I'm in Tennessee for Tums. Okay. So for those of you who are just joining, specifically my one friend Marley, I drank an entire container of gas station eggnog. Super worth it. It tasted really good. Who would have thought that if you just put a bunch of sugar in something, it might taste good? I had half a gas station hot dog, which was also surprisingly delicious. I had a bite of a barbecue riblet, which I immediately threw in the trash, which made me feel bad for the garbage. And now we're going to top things off with a bite of a gas station fruitcake. Merry Christmas, everybody. Oh. I'll be right back. Oh, God. Oh, God, why? Why did I pick this career? Why? Why couldn't I just write jokes like normal people? Oh, I'm gonna turn my body into a fucking hilarious comedy sketch for 55 people on Facebook. Hey, sorry, I had to step out for a second. Yeah, so this fruitcake tastes like what I imagine IKEA furniture does. It tastes like particle board with raisins in it. Okay, yep. Time number three, okay? This is my stomach turning on me for the third time. And really, what did it do to deserve this? This stomach could have been given to anybody. I'm gonna put this fruitcake in the garbage. No, yeah, I know, Johnny. I know fruitcake is traditionally good. This is not very good fruitcake. Okay. Oh, God. Oh, why? What? Okay. Say goodbye to hot dog wood. Say goodbye to eggnog. Let's see. Hey, sir, do you want this fruitcake? Okay, he said no. All right. Well, so long, fruitcake. Speaking of so long, that's about it for me, because that's all the money I had on me. Otherwise, we would still be eating garbage. My name is Asterios Koganos, and if you want to support me going to the hospital later, you can go to patreon.com/Asterios. If you donate even $1, you will get some pretty cool stuff. Follow me on Twitter, @Asterios, and follow me to the morgue, RIP 2016. You guys take care. You have a good one, okay? Goodbye, Chris. Goodbye, Jake. Goodbye, everybody.